don't need a return ticket where you're going. This is a one-way journey.
Straight down!
Series. Yes, the powers that be have decided that too much fun can be hell. And so, from next week, there'll be something slightly poorer on in this time slot. For now, however, it's time for another onslaught into the deep, dark bowels of hell. And leading the ranks of the fallen for a final time, we have our first challenge. So it's over to Games Master.
My first challenge promises some top arcade antics. As contestants slug it out on the action-packed beat-em-up Dark Stalkers. The two characters I've selected, Wolf and Bishano, are equipped with some effective special moves and should provide an entertaining bout of fisticuffs.
Please welcome our first challengers today, Gil Kaiden and Stephen Coughlin. Gil, what kind of music are you into?
Heavy metal.
Heavy metal. Let's talk about hair and heavy metal, because they're very hirsute fellows, all these guys. What's your favourite heavy metal hairstyle?
No hair.
No hair?
Yeah, it's the best.
Who's got no hair in heavy metal?
Scott Ian's from Anthrax.
Right, and you're into the no hair thing. You don't like all the ringlets and stuff like that. All right, that's fine. We're happy with that. Now, Stephen, you want to be an actor?
Yeah, trying to.
Yeah, go on then, do some acting.
Blank.
That's very good, though. I like that. That was acting a blank. And what kind of roles, though, would you like to do? Serious roles? Comedy roles? Cheese roles?
Action roles.
Better Sylvester Stallone?
Schwarzenegger.
Well, I can see it. I can see it, the likeness.
Okay.
All right, then. While we talk more about acting and the state of ringlets and heavy metal, we'll go to today's news. First, news of a new system aiming to make record stores a thing of the past, the digital jukebox. Choose the single you want on your PC, and about 10 minutes later, it'll come via the phone lines onto your hard drive, ready to be played as many times as you can bear. The system can store up to 400,000 songs, and it's hoped that it'll cost as little as 40 pence a single, and with unsigned band tracks available free. Whether you'll be able to get Take That or Oasis this way depends on whether record companies concerned think the profit margins are big enough. Don't hold your breath.
I want to provide material for the kids that's going to bring them closer to Christ. There's so much out there that's negative and destructive.
Indeed. The latest craze over in the States for those people tired of antisocial games is for more religious adventures, exemplified by titles like this one. Defender of the Faith, in which you play the youthful King David and have to prove your mettle by, amongst other things, slaying Goliath. And, of course, if religious games are big in the States, it won't be long before they'll be over here too. And finally, the big film hitting cinemas this week is the futuristic space adventure Stargate. And for the first time, those that like it can buy a CD-ROM about its making. For 30 quid, you can wander around computer-generated versions of the set, find out how the special effects were made, and even decide which questions to put to stars like Kurt Russell, such as, Kurt, why the cack hair? Answer, it goes with the film. Right, what's the title? Oh, it's Hanky's on the Head time. It means it's Dave Perry. Dave, where does the bandana sleep at night?
The bandana sleeps, it sleeps just beside my bed. It's got its own little closet room. It's got a television in there. I look after my bandanas.
Okay, and special moves, Dave, once more, please.
Well, John Tulbane is a wolf, and Gil will be playing as him. He has a fireball move. He also has a howling at the moon wolf move, which acts like a dragon punch as he leaps upwards. And then Bishamu is a samurai, and he tends to use his sword. He can throw that, or he can slice in a very wide arc around himself.
Okay, best of luck to both our competitors. Gil and Steve, let them. The fight begin. Okay, we can see Gil is playing John Tobin, who's the wolf on the left, and Steve is
Sharma, who's the Simonite guy on the right. Energy Blast is always at the top of the screen when the go red, you're completely dead. Pretty evenly matched so far, Dave.
It's pretty evenly matched so far, yes it is. The two energy bars this game has, which are special, are at the bottom, the special bars. Now that the higher they are, the more powerful the moves that fighter can pull off. But at the moment, the energy bars are very low. Fisherman, John Talbot.
Oh dear, John Talbot takes the first one, but Sharma collapses. 1-0 to go. Okay, off we go for the second bite. Gill is 1-0 up. He's the Wolf guy on the left. Okay, we're really hoping this Steve's going to come back now. What's some of his samurai moves then?
Well, samurai moves, he can throw his sword and he can slice in a very wide arc around himself.
I reckon he wants to do that because whenever this Wolf's getting in close, it's causing havoc.
That's right, he can fireball himself in close, but he can do the howling move, which is like a dragon punch.
Bishamu's energy is low again now, Dave.
So is John Talbane's going to be the next move.
But very close, and Bishamu pulls it level. One by all. And we go into the third and final bout.
We've had some very close and even matches in this series, haven't we?
We certainly have.
With a lot of comebacks. And that's the fireball move. John told me he doesn't just fire a fireball, he actually turns himself into one and shoots across the screen at Bishamu.
So you can see Little Bob in the background getting a bit carried away by all as well.
Little Dog's getting a bit upset by the fact that Jay Tolman is taking a bit of a beating at the moment.
A couple of cute little kids in the neck. I don't know why they're watching.
Streets when this kind of thing is going on.
Both of them
there we go, that's it, Bishamu's down.
And the saves, Bishamu down, John Cobble wins, Gill is the winner.
Okay, now, Gill, that was quite close, really, wasn't it? But it was the special moves, I think, made the difference in the end. Give us your opinion of the fight.
It's a good fight.
That's one heck of an opinion there, Gill, eh?
Yeah.
Well, yep.
That was the best, so I won.
You were? Yeah. I can't fault you in that opinion. Stephen, give us your excuse.
It was close, and that's all I can say.
That's not an excuse. I don't know what that is, but it's not an excuse. What is it?
Well, we're more in practice, so.
Yeah. Oh, well, that's all right then, Stephen, because you were more in practice, but Gil gets the joystick, and you're happier that way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, and with that, let's present Gil with the Games Master Golden Joystick. Question is, with this being the final show, how will you live without our reviewers when the show's not on air? Well, that's not really my problem, is it? Let's find out their final opinions. Get on your bike, as some bloke once said, so saddle up with Cheeky Norm for a dose of Road Rash 3.
They've actually taken the sprites from the 3DO version and scaled them down to fit on the Mega Drive. In terms of gameplay, there's only really one new option, and that's that you can climb on another opponent's bike when he gets knocked off.
If you've already got a Road Rash game, don't bother buying this. The Road Rash 3 has got split-screen two-player mode. It's slightly faster and better looking than the preceding two games, but virtually the same game.
People who have motorbikes are sure to love this sort of game. Not fair, not nice, but pretty good fun nonetheless.
I'm sure I'm not the only one whose pants have been pooed waiting for LucasArts Star Wars shoot 'em up, but has Dark Forces been worth the wait?
Well, the first things I noticed about this game is just like the attention to detail. It is absolutely brilliant. However, there's no blood in it, there's no chainsaws, you know, I mean, what can I say? Doom rules.
The graphics are actually better than Doom. It's a little faster and a little smoother. What this game adds to the Doom scenario, though, is strategy. Instead of just shooting everything, you actually have a mission to accomplish, which is to steal the plans for the Death Star.
It's actually more impressive technically than Doom or Doom 2, simply because you have more depth of vision. Not only can you look straight ahead, but you can also look up and down, you can jump up steps, and there's a wider variety of terrains that you have to get through.
It certainly looks different, but is Uniracers original and addictive, or just plain silly, childish and immature?
The simple objective is to reach the end of the course, and you have to beat the computer player or your human opponent in two-player mode. In order to build up speed, you have to perform a series of stunts. You can do flips and somersaults and spins and all kinds of stuff like that.
I found it quite simply one of the best two-player games I've found in ages. It's totally addictive. You learn as you go, and as you find new tricks and new somersaults to do, it becomes even more compelling.
You're just trying to race each other to the end, and you know, you might just get pipped to the post, and it's really annoying, especially when you know someone who you know you can beat just pips you with like, a little extra move. It's pretty annoying, but great fun.
For home reviewers out there, this week's Gameland game is Scottish Open Golf. You can download a demo of this PC game by connecting your modem to 081 558 8937. Apart from the call to London, the service is free, but remember to get permission from whichever fool pays your bills.
As tonight's celebrity prepares to stare into the black abyss of potential humiliation, let's find out what our challenge is.
I am something of a practical joker. And my next challenge, Crazy Chase on the Super Nintendo, is full of slapstick hijinks. Players have 1 minute to collect as many coins as possible while avoiding the host of humiliating hazards that bar their way. I think I'm going to enjoy this.
So now let's jump in whoop for tonight's incredibly special star guest, the sexiest thing in Ramsey Street since Madge left, Natalie Imbruglia.
They're very excited there. That was very coquettish there. Little coquettish wave. Natalie, I want to talk about the pressures of being a sex symbol.
Oh, gosh. I don't think of myself as a sex symbol.
No, I was talking about me.
Oh, sorry.
That was a very unrehearsed gag, that one. No, do you get stopped in the street? Do you get hassle from people?
Yeah, but the haircut's helped a bit. I'm not recognisable.
Yeah. Do you not like your new hair?
Oh, it's okay. I'm getting used to it. Yeah. It's just a nice change.
Yeah. Joining Natalie tonight and fulfilling the fantasy of many young boys at his age, please welcome Scott Bradley. Welcome, Scott. Okay. Yeah. Scott, why are you blushing?
Well, you know.
Listen, Scott, I know you're from Milton Keynes, aren't you, Scott?
Yeah, that's right. Actually, it's not quite Milton Keynes. It's more near Newport Pagnell, a little village called Stoke-on-Tone.
Right. Does that make a difference?
No.
If you were to explain to Natalie what makes Milton Keynes such a great place to live, how would you do it?
It's because I live there, basically, so you've got to run it.
That sounds fair enough, and while we ruminate on the stories behind other sad British towns, we'll go to a commercial break. Very lucky tonight because we have young Scott Bradley and he's playing against neighbour sex siren Natalie Imbruglia. The temperature's 10 degrees hotter. It's probably got nothing to do with Scott. First in the queue to join me tonight with Steve Merritt, surprisingly enough, from Mean Machines. Hello, Steve.
Hey, Tom.
Steve, which one of the neighbour's girlies do you fancy the most?
Well, Paul Robbins has always been my hero, so like him, I'm going to have the twins.
Twins, hopefully they'll get time off from those shampoo commercials.
Yeah, they say put clean hair.
Any tips? What tips have you got for Scott and Natalie on this, Steve?
Basically, to make the clown run faster, pull the joypad down. That way you're going to get the chance to collect more objects faster. I mean, bumping into things is going to be hazardous, but if you've got the speed, I reckon you'll crack it.
Okay, both Natalie and Scott have 1 minute to collect as many coins as they can. Scott's going first. Best of luck, Scott. Let your challenge begin.
Stop the game!
Steve, any tips for Natalie?
Basically, just make sure she gets down a lot faster than that.
Okay, best of luck, Natalie. Your 1 minute starts now. And off Natalie goes, look at that.
She's off already. Look at that for
speed. She's sitting in a great position.
Already in for a bonus. She's spotted at the balloon side. All the bonuses. Here comes the log. She's going to have to jump to avoid that.
Second span, and she's looking quite...
She's on the log. She's managed to roll along on the log now. That makes her go a lot faster.
She's wasted a bit of time, though.
She's got to go down a lot faster, or she's just not going to get any
more
bonuses.
Points. Congratulations, Natalie. Scott, I'll start with you. Scott, was your heart beating a little faster towards the end there?
Well, yeah, I couldn't stand that bridge, and, well, she was doing a bit good, so... Well.
I was going to say, you should have been looking at the screen then.
She should have won, because she was very good.
Yeah. That's very giving of you, Scott. You're obviously after a snog or something, aren't you?
Well, of course. Who wouldn't?
Natalie, the snog you can sort out in you and Scott's own time, but Natalie, I have to tell you, Steve and I were very tired and emotional up there in the box towards the end. Every last drop of energy we had was focused on you. What went wrong?
Well, I didn't do too badly. I think I made a few mistakes that couldn't be fixed, but I did okay, didn't I?
Yeah. And they're really going to disagree with you, Natalie. I don't think so. But unfortunately, didn't do quite well enough because the winner of the golden joystick on this occasion is Scott Bradley. Yeah. So now it's time for Games Master's font of knowledge to spray forth in liberal doses as we all splash around in the consultation zone.
Hello, and welcome to what, for me, is a very sad, sad moment. The consultation zone.
Games Master, I love all the levels on Zero Squirrel, but is there any way of getting straight to them?
Where there's a will, there's a way. Pause the game and enter this code. A, C, R, A, B. You'll receive a gold American Express card accepted in every single one of the zero levels. That should keep you in credit.
Thanks a lot, Games Master.
That'll do nicely. Next, please.
Games Master, on King of Fighters 94, I keep on getting beaten up. Give us a hand.
When you've been beaten up on this beat-em-up, so much that your character becomes stunned, push B and C together. And you'll find a healthy teammate will come to your rescue, giving you valuable time to recover.
Thanks, Games Master.
I'll have the very last one, please, and not a minute too soon.
I think I've seen all the levels on Probotector on the Mega Drive. Can this be so?
Well, I just may know of a little secret tranny to poke your nose into. On the level where you're being attacked by the bikers, you will come to a wall with writing on it. Most people shoot the doors here. Don't. Jump above the door and climb the wall, and you'll reach a guard with a question for you. Accept his invitation, and you will find yourself in a hidden arena with some extremely difficult bosses to battle with. You're on your own now.
Thanks, Games Master. You've been a real help.
Well, that's it for me and the consultation zone, at least for now. I'm sure there are a million other little queries out there, and I'd love to see them all, maybe next time. Ta-ta.
As you know, I am officially the hardest presenter on Channel 4. This is why I've been invited out to Los Angeles onto the set of the hardest film of the year, Mortal Kombat, to have a little chat with the boys and girls who are making the film.
New Line Cinema, makers of The Mask and Nightmare on Elm Street movies, have pulled out all the stops for Mortal Kombat, making it their highest budget venture to date. It tells the tale of three fighters who are led by Thunder God Raiden to the Outworld, where they must defend the Earth by winning the Mortal Kombat tournament. Our three heroes being Liu Kang, Johnny Cage, and my favourite, Sonya Blade. Now, Bridget, you play Sonya Blade in the movie. Tell me a little bit about what she gets up to in the film.
Well, Sonya is the character that is, she's a female that's very strong, that's very tough. Yeah. She's one of those women that if anything gets in her way, yeah, it doesn't stop her still. And if she needs help,
it's like
she'll
like my mum.
No one, really.
My mum's like that, funny enough. Yeah.
Okay, so you can relate. And she, you know, when they embark upon this adventure with the characters Johnny and Lou, mm-hmm, she's the, in the beginning, she's the unwilling outcast of the group until she kind of really begins to realize what's going on, because she has no idea what Mortal Kombat is.
The essence of Mortal Kombat is not about death, but life.
How hard are you in real life? Are you quite tough in real life outside of the film?
It depends on if I like you or not.
Well, say Martina Navratilova. Could you take, like, Martina, do you think? Could you take her in a one-on-one situation?
Okay, the better question would be, who couldn't I?
Okay. The only genuine martial arts expert in the film is Robin Hsu, who plays General Top Rope Liu Kang.
Now, Robin, you play Liu Kang, one of the good guys. Is it really? I mean, a lot of people say, you know, that obviously making films is very, very hard work, but then you got the people saying, no, it's not. It's easy. You just sit around and do a couple of minutes filming and that's it. Has it been hard?
It's pretty hard, pretty hard.
Yeah.
Especially doing martial arts movie. Mm-hmm. It is so physical, and people sometimes don't realize that you have to act. Mm-hmm. And do all these fight sequences.
Uh-huh.
And that is very strenuous, I find.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, bearing in mind then that you are a martial arts expert, if you were going down a dark alley one night, mm-hmm, and the whole of New Kids on the Block were there blocking each end of the alley.
Okay.
How would that go, that fight?
Well, I mean, I think I can take them all, you know.
Yeah.
But I think their fans gonna kill me afterward.
What a ghastly thought. As well as good guys, of course, Mortal Kombat's got plenty of bad guys. Mighty Morphin Shang Tsung, as well as cold-hearted product of a broken home, Sub-Zero. And in a special effects frenzy, even Goro makes an appearance, but we were too scared to have a look. A more complicated character is portrayed by Talisa Soto, who takes the role of the enigmatic mega bird, Princess Katana.
You're finally learning, Liu Kang.
Katana.
Come with me. We must hurry.
However much I tried to talk about the film, it became patently obvious Talisa fancied me. Right, Talisa, you play Katana in the film, who's like...
Princess Katana.
Princess Katana, sorry, I stand corrected. Who's like 2,000 years old.
10,000 years old.
10,000 years old.
I corrected
good,
twice.
Am I? But you look very young and fit, do you know what I mean? For like 10,000 years old.
It's that bloodline in our world.
Yeah, did you see she just winked at me, by the way? Talisa so wise, she winked at me. So what are you doing after this then, Talisa?
Well, there's nothing signed yet, but a couple things in the burner. We'll
no, I meant after this tonight.
After tonight?
Like I'm in town.
Oh, yeah?
Do you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah?
We could do something if you wanted, yeah? Yeah, would you be up for that?
Sure. One of those days that is not, you know, those crack of dawn calls.
Yeah, that's cool.
Okay?
I've scored. The film, released later this year, will have a PG-13 rating, so don't expect the gore of the game. But with tons of suspense, action and special effects ahoy, it will be equally groovy. Well, sadly, that's it for another series of Games Master. Over the past 18 weeks, we've laughed, we've cried, but most importantly, we've upset a lot of old people. We're off now to do something nice. Goodbye, boys and girls.
We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Actually, that's not quite it, because late this Friday night at 12:35, you'll be able to see the infamous Games Master Gore Special, a show so thoroughly reprehensible, Channel 4 refused to let the show it any earlier.